Now that your Azure Static Web App is deployed in Azure, I want to show you in this video how you could leverage that CI/CD that you just create to preview some change from your code. I'm Frank Boucher, and today we're talking Azure Static Web App. Now that your static app is deployed in Azure, I want to show you how you could use that CI/CD that you just create to preview some changes. So here in GitHub, when you create a GitHub action, it's visible in this tab, but it's all defined in a file. So let's have a look. So this file is here, under the subfolder GitHub and workflows. Let's have a look. So we'll open this and open the file. And now we could see that the first thing that is declared, defined, it's the name of our process, and then the trigger. So right now I'm looking for the event push and pull request. Right now I'm only looking for the branch main. It could be something else, or it could be multiple branch that I'm looking at. And for pull request, I'm looking also at many different event type, and it's really useful because we will be using this in this video. Secondly, it's the job. So there's two jobs right now. Let's have a look to the first one. I'll try to put that in the screen. So what it does a checkout, getting your code, and then it will build and deploy. And that's really interesting because whatever you're using, different kind of JavaScript framework or even C#, this step will take your code, process it, or maybe compile it if it's in C#, and then move that to Azure. To get access to Azure, it will use here the secrets. Those secrets are defined inside the GitHub secrets section in the settings. They are very, very secure. Those are the credentials you need to get access to your resource group in Azure. And now we need to specify where is the thing we want to move to Azure. So this is done with those three properties just here. So the location app, this is where my code is. The API location, if you have one, this is where the API code is. And then the output location, sometime if we're using, I don't know, TypeScript or C#, the code and the output artifact are different. So this is why we have those two, and that's the artifact that will be pushed. The value in there are highly customizable. It depends on the framework you're using or your favorite location. You need to customize it the way you want. And now let's have a look to the last job just here. So right now this one is focusing on the pull request. And when we create a new pull request, that will create a staging environment, kind of a new deployment slot inside Azure. And this way we'll have two different versions of our application available online, sharing the same resources. This is very useful. But then when we're done, maybe we merge, maybe we just close that pull request, we need to get rid of that staging environment. And that's what that task does. It informs Azure using our, again, our special secret token to delete that staging environment. Let's have a look and try to do one. So I just want to show you briefly the app I'm using. So right now that's the current version in production, and I want to change the color in this menu. So right now it's dark to kind of purple. So I want to change it, make it a little bit more colorful. So I'll go here in the code. I will go back to the root of my repo, and I want to create a new branch. So here I'll just call that branch demo. So I will create here. Obviously you could use different tool. I'm using GitHub interface because it's available for everyone. And now I want to change the code of my app. So for me, I know that it's in the folder app, and then it's in the folder shared, and I want to change that CSS. So we'll click on that. Because I want to edit it, I will click this little pen, and that's the value here I want to change. Just put something else. Now I need some commit message. Voila, commit the change. And now if I look my GitHub action, nothing is showing up, nothing is running. Why? Because my trigger is only looking for pull requests or the branch main. And I'm right now I'm in the branch demo. So there's nothing happening. If I want to trigger that new environment, I need to create a pull request. So let's do that. So if I go back to code, I see here demo as change and I can compare and create a pull request. That's excellent. We'll do that. And I'll just click that pull request button. It takes a few seconds for the GitHub action, the workflow to get triggered, and it will generate something here. That's wonderful. But you know what? I have already something prepared, so we don't need to wait. So let's have a look. So if we'll go again in the branch, we see I had the final. So I create the same thing, but in advance. And if we go in the pull request, I have another pull request that is already ready. So after a little while, the pull request will compile, deploy your code in that staging environment, and you will have this status. And here, your Static Web App staging environment is ready, and you could see it here. So if I click on that, now I will have my new menu with dark purple and pink. I like that. I will suggest this, but my version is already present. Both are right now in Azure, sharing the same environment. And we can also see that from the portal. So if I go in the portal, the portal.azure.com, this is my static web app. And I have a bunch of information. So see here, I have my URL. And if I go in environment, in the left panel, I will see here staging. And I will see just here my branch where I did with the title of my pull request and everything that is available. So I could see everything here. And when I'm done, I could merge, I could delete, that environment will be deleted. That's how you could leverage the CI/CD from GitHub to see preview of your code in your static web app. Stay tuned for learning more.